happen. The Saxon 8-7 lesson number 53. Everybody lean in and say hi. Wave your hand all over. They have issues, what can I say? Okay, so we're gonna be talking about multiplying rates. So if we're traveling in a car, going 50 miles an hour, and we've traveled for 4 hours, how far have we gone? I know this is easy, but we're gonna still kind of work it through. So 4 hours times 50 miles an hour for 1 hour, right, 50 miles an hour. We can cancel out our hours, and 4 times 50 is what?
200.
And we have traveled 200 miles in the 4 hours. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
We can find how long it will take to travel 300 miles.
Yeah.
300 miles. But we're going 50 miles an hour.
Yeah.
We need to divide then by 50. Miles an hour in 1 hour. Oops. 1 hour. So how do I do this? It's a fraction. How do I divide fractions? Anyone? Anyone? How do I divide fractions?
You can.
So what you do is you put the one on the right upside down and just multiply.
It's also called its
reciprocal.
So then I would say 300 miles times 1 hour over 50 miles.
And then you can pre-reduce.
These guys get.
You can pre-reduce.
Right? And now I can pre-reduce. Well, one of the zeros goes away and 5 goes into 30 how many times?
Six.
So I'm left with?
Six hours.
It's a really long time in the car.
Oh.
I suggest just driving faster.
I'm
just saying.
I just prefer an airplane.
So, notice that we divided the rate by similar by dividing a fraction. We actually multiply by the reciprocal, blah, blah, blah. Okay. The following statement expresses rate. There were 5 chairs in each row. We can express this by saying 5 chairs in 1 row. In 1 row, or we can say 1 row has 5 chairs. Using the rate, we can find the number of chairs in 6 rows. So, if I have 5 chairs in 1 row, how many chairs do I have in 6 rows?
So you can multiply.
Right? I'm just going to.
6 rows times 5 chairs.
Well, but do you see the problem? I've actually done this wrong because the rows are on the wrong side.
Dun.
Some of the pens have that, some don't.
Dun, dun.
Dun. 6 rows. The rows get crossed out, and 5 times 6 is?
30 chairs.
30 chairs.
Can I throw that many a jar?
Okay. All right. We can also find the number of rows we need for 20 chairs. Chairs, right? But I know again that 5 chairs in each row. So I'm going to divide that by 5 chairs in each row, right? And I remember I have to do what when I am dividing fractions? I need to multiply by the
reciprocal. You already gave us half the
history. Yes, the chairs go away. And 5 goes into 20 4 times, and now I know I need 4 rows.
Yep.
No, 4 robots.
Robots, yeah. Robots.
Robots.
I think this is fairly easy. I don't know if I really need, do I need to go through these with you guys?
What is it?
This is easy, right? Is this easy?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to do the rest of the examples because I think that it's probably easy enough for you guys. That was lesson number 53. Let's see if this works. No, not today. Bye-bye.